Hey guys, this video is going to be about whether we should put lime fertilizer or any amendments to the soil, or putting improved species of forages. And also I'm going to talk about reseeding your pasture fields naturally, just by letting your grasses go to seed or your forages go to seed. Enjoy the video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, share with a friend. Check out in the description below, we have some links to some products that we use regularly here on the farm. And also, we have a new merch store. If you, we're having a run around here this morning, I guess. Everybody's feeling good, kicking their heels up. Just moved them into this paddock. And go find your calf. Stop yelling and go find your calf. Jeez. Okay guys, what I wanted to show you here is this section here is a control area. This is an area that I have done nothing on the farm other than graze. And I've done high stock density graze, and I've done everything that I could possibly think of to try and bring it back to a highly productive system. But unfortunately, I've not been able to do that. You can see there's not much in here. There's a lot of sweet vernal. There's a little bit of clover. Up in this area up here, there is a little bit more forage. So it's not like I'm showing you the worst of the worst. It's pretty even across here, other than there is a little more forage right in there for some reason, I don't know. This has been in permanent pasture for a really long time, but we cover cropped that. It would have been back in probably 2013 sometime. We put chicory, winter rye, annual ryegrass, and radishes in here. And then that following spring, that would have been planted in the fall, and then the following spring we come in and we planted this orchard grass, fescue. Here's some bird's foot trefoil. It's about 16, 18 inches tall. Lots of clover in here. And that's the difference. You know, so I guess, you know, do we apply amendments? I contribute this field here being nicer compared to this one because of the lime. Another thing that I wanted to show you, it's really unique about this field. It was starting to thin on me a little bit because we've done some winter grazing in here. And we've been in here in pretty wet conditions. We never really pugged it up, but we did kill some of the plants in here. So it was thinning. I was thinking about redoing some stuff in here. But last year we let the clover and the orchard grass go to seed before we grazed it. And if we look at the understory, cows just got done grazing this. It's grazed down probably an average. On average, it's probably 8 inches tall yet. But if we look at the understory, look at these little clover plants that are regrowing. So this field is gonna be nothing but orchard grass, bird's foot trefoil, and lots of clover. There's gonna be a lot of clover in here. I don't see much orchard grass growing, but those little seedlings have, their filaments are about the size of a human hair when they first start growing, so they're really hard to see, and I'm sure that they're there. But that is really cool how we were able to reseed this clover back into this field. And it's gonna be a phenomenal field here come this fall when we start grazing it again. or actually probably winter, because I've decided that orchard grass is probably one of the best stockpiled forages out there, especially for in February, February-ish. In the last 2 years, we've been on this field, somewhere on this field, on the 1st of January. In the last 2 years, we've been on this field. So, you know, should we apply fertilizer or lime and put improved forage seeds down? In my opinion, it depends on the case and the need for forage. But yes, I believe that at some point, you know, to make your fields more productive, especially on small acreage when you're dependent on a lot of acreage or a little acreage with a lot of animals. Here on our farm, our carrying capacity is one animal unit per 1.62 acres for over 300 days a year, which is a very, very heavy stock or carrying capacity on the farm, and it's getting better every year. So just throwing that out there, guys. Wanted to show you that. It's a night and day difference. Okay, guys, hopefully you found that video useful. If you would, don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, share with a friend, and check out the links that we have in the description below. We'll talk to you later. Have a good one.